rivalry as we've ever seen. It goes beyond titles. It goes beyond bragging rights. It goes straight to the core of what makes a man, if you will. That is woman. And Kimberly Page is the pawn in the war between DDP and Buff Bagwell.
Well, I hope that Doug Dillinger, head of WCW security, was taking notes. And I hope that there's extra security this Monday in Buffalo, New York, at the Marine Midland Arena for Nitro. Because I don't think that there's any way that we're going to be able to keep Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell separated until next Sunday, 1 week from tomorrow, when they battle and sold out.
I hope whoever is booking the talent for the next 8 days has sense enough to keep those two off the same flight, out of the same hotel, and preferably off of the same live event until we get to sold out.
You know, it's not going to be a wrestling match that's sold out between these two. It's going to be another chapter in this war between Diamond Dallas Page and Buff Bagwell. Need proof that it's not going to be a wrestling match? No rules, no referee, plain and simple, last man standing wins.
And with the intensity that's built up between those two athletes, we may not get a winner. There may not be one man standing. They both may knock themselves in the next week. That hatred is so intense. Disco Inferno and Scott Armstrong doing battle here on Saturday night. World Tag Team Champions still to come. Tony Bag of Donuts, Big Vito, and Johnny the Ball at ringside for Disco. Oh! Scott Armstrong dotting his eye for it.
You know, I'm not sure if that trio around ringside is here to support Disco Inferno or just to keep an eye on him to make sure that he does things their way.
Well, so far, Disco has made up on $100 of the $25,000 he owes to the Marinara family.
Yeah, but he's out of Rolex.
That's worth more than $100 unless he bought it from Heenan. Into the corner. One to the gut. Armstrong. Face jam on Disco. That may do about $400 worth of improvements. No, two count before Disco powers up.
You know, we've always questioned the focus and the concentration level of the Disco Inferno. Well, I think ever since the problems came to light that he had with Tony Marinara, Big Vito, and Johnny the Bull, and the Big Boss as well,
oh, yeah.
I think that level of concentration for Disco has gone right out the window.
Oh, no, he's concentrating. He's focused. It's just not on wrestling. He's focused on saving his own skin. Really doing a number on Scott Armstrong. Oh, careful camera guy. That's about $30,000 worth of equipment there.
Yeah, but also be careful camera guy, because Big Vito is not somebody that you want to mess with.
Not hardly. Oh, inverted atomic drop from Disco. Side rushes, leg sweep, nailed it. Armstrong tried to fight out of it, but no go. Disco lateral press. Only a two count, not a 6 foot cover.
Although you do have to give Disco credit for trying to go for the win. A couple of quick offensive moves, and oh, with authority. Back first goes Scott Armstrong into those corner turnbuckles.
Into the throat of Scott Armstrong, Disco Inferno. A little more brutal technician in the ring than we've seen of late. And you noticed earlier on, Big Vito and Johnny the Bull not letting Disco get any dance moves in before the match.
Well, thankfully,
I'm not complaining. I'm just saying that's going to help.
That's one of the positives to having Tony Marinara, Big Vito, and Johnny the Bull accompany Disco to the ring.
It might be the only one, but works for me. Scott Armstrong in the ropes. Disco back elbow. Right into the chest. That'll take your breath away. Nope, Disco tried the little wiggle. Not the little wiggle, not the Roman Spotty little wiggle, but the John Travolta wiggle. No go. Got cut off by Big Vito.
Go!
Much more effective offensive maneuver there.
Again, remember, yet to come in this broadcast, World Tag Team titles at stake. What do you call them? The crazies? Just plain nuts? David Flair and Crowbar?
That's them.
Belts go on the line. Yet to come tonight against Steven Regal and David Taylor. Every tag team in WCW thinks they've got a shot at wearing the gold.
I hope that the goddess herself, Daphne Younger, comes out with the Badlander.
Well, she's here, isn't she?
I hope so. Something about her, you know?
What is it?
I don't know. Look at the smell. Disco from the middle turnbuckle. We're going to drop the elbow. Nobody home. Oh, look at Scott Armstrong go. The Armstrongs have had a run of luck on Saturday night. It may continue here. I don't know if the Armstrongs want to make the family mad, but they're doing it. Scott Armstrong taking over on Disco. That's it. Shoots him in the ropes. Big back body drop. Former TV champ, former cruiserweight champ Disco.
Wait a second.
Johnny the Bull caught one. Tony Marinaro. Look at that.
Hey, he just passed something in.
Crapped up.
Oh, sure it is. Disco just put it right on his hand and...
I missed it. The brass knucks didn't pay off. Disco into the ropes. Oh, he got it that time.
Lights out for Scott Armstrong.
Oh, and the toss to ringside. Oh, that's it. Academic and three. Disco Inferno with an assist to Big Vito. And the brass knuckles and Johnny the Bull and Tony Bag of Donuts. It was 4.5 on 1. Scott Armstrong could not overcome the odds.